Mustard Seed School was founded 27 years ago after a lady by the name of Karen Banker was a volunteer at Mary House, and she saw that children were coming in every day with their mothers and they really weren't being educated. And she saw a need there, so she created the Mustard Seed School. And basically we are an emergency school for homeless children. An emergency school is basically a school where when a kid, maybe they've just found themselves in a situation of homelessness. The kids may be living at a shelter or in a car, in a tent, under a bridge somewhere, or in a motel. And an emergency school is an opportunity where kids can continue to come to school, be educated, be fed. Parents and kids can receive additional services. And then once the sort of crisis is over, then we transition the kids back into public schools. For some kids, it's only a couple of days, but then unfortunately we do have some that they're here for a couple months, and we want the crisis to end as quickly as possible.
My daughter, Chriselle, she's talking more. So that's a good thing because she was quiet a lot and now she has friends to play with. She's learning more. They're telling me stuff that I didn't even know. It's funny, my daughter, she's in a class of second graders and she's learning how to write nicely. Or she's learning how to, what animals eat what and how a butterfly eats. They want to learn. Like if we miss a day of school, I get yelled at from the kids because why can't we go? It's Monday, it's a holiday. Why don't they have school on a holiday? I think school, with the hours that she's here, they're here, it's good because they don't realize all the trouble that we're having. They're just having fun and learning here. School really helped because if we don't have nothing to eat, they will give us a bag of, like, a big old grocery bag full of food, water, and just everything that we need.
Families learn about the Mustard Seed School through a variety of ways, but we also have outreach who goes out to the hotels and touches base with families who are living in hotels and just tells them about the services that we have to offer and what we can do and how we can assist them not only in getting enrolled, but even with future services as far as maybe housing or employment or transitioning back into public school.
The biggest things I have to offer the families is that peace that I've been here and I've been where they've been. I'll often tell our families, I sat in this same chair and enrolled my daughter. It's great when I can open the conversation in that way because it does make the families feel more open and less judged because I get to share my story with them. It's humbling, it's hard. It's hard to ask for help. And so when I can have that conversation and let them know that I've been where they've been, you just see the relief wash over them.
It's been helpful because I can look for a place, an apartment, without all my kids screaming and yelling. I can go to an interview that I will have to be at for 2.5 hours, but I don't have the kids yelling and screaming. I think for the people who are homeless and not letting their kids come, they should, because it will give them a break of just being free, just because kids don't really need to know all the grown-ups' business and how struggling we really are. Just go have fun and be free.
Our funding comes strictly from private donations, organizations, individuals who walk in off the street and feel as strongly about what we do as we do. Our donations come from those who care enough about the kids that we serve to want to help and be a part of that. The support of the community here in Sacramento has been overwhelming. And I think deep down in, they still care about these kids. And the idea of homeless children sleeping in tents or sleeping in cars or under bridges, it's real. I think it's just people getting behind that and realizing that one person can make all the difference in the world. As far as to pinpoint exactly right now is what's the best way to help, probably the best thing to do is to call the school and say, at this point of the year, what are your biggest needs? Sometimes it is hard to have enough coats for the kids or shoes. Sometimes we do run low on snacks. Our needs change about as rapidly as our enrollment changes.
A lot of times we don't realize what homelessness does to a child. One of the stories that I share a lot is there was a probably 12 or 13 year old child who was here. And one of the things he said was like, oh, I'm so glad I get to come to Mustard Seed now. And he just said, you know, I don't have to lie anymore. Some of the kids would ask to come over to my house and play video games or to stay the night. And he was too embarrassed to tell them that he was in a shelter, so he would make things up. If you notice, every classroom has the daily routine on it, from time, what time this is gonna happen, what time that's gonna happen. And that little thing alone gives a child a little bit of control on their lives. They may not know where they're gonna stay at tonight, they may not know where they're gonna be at tomorrow, but they do know what's gonna happen here.
These kids are happy, they're healthier, they're getting healthier, and they enjoy coming to school. When they come through, it's a rainy day, they're wet from walking to school, but yet they still come through the door with a smile on their face and they're waving and they're just excited to be here.
Something our founder, Karen Banker, said is that
academics give us a vehicle to provide structure and a safe, nurturing environment, which is what we want for the children. And that's what Mustard Seed is.
The thing I hate the most is at the end of the day when you see kids leaving and you see them walking down the street carrying a sleeping bag under their arm and their backpack, and you know that that backpack is full of snacks or their clothes, not what most kids carry in their backpacks. And you see those kids disappear into the crowd of people and you go home and then you worry about them. And then the next morning you come in and there comes that kid back through the front door again and you just breathe. You just breathe a sigh of relief because you know they survived one more day. And it's tough. It's tough. But it makes it worth it.